I was just going to ask, with all of the albums you've made, with this new album Solid, is there a direct is where are you thinking or feeling that is do you even have an idea of where you might want to explore next? Because I feel like with someone who's covered so much, it'd be very interesting to know what you feel you haven't explored, or is there something you feel like you haven't touched on yet?
Well, I mean, every record is sort of a journey of discovery for me. I mean, I think of each record seems to have its own character, and it's all based on just the ideas that pop into my head at that time, though. I mean, every couple of years I make a record, it seems. I think it was almost 3 years for this one, but after I turn a record in, there's always a sort of a fallow period creatively for me. It's almost like I've had a baby, and I can't imagine having another baby. I'm not writing now. But eventually I'm just going to get the urge, and I'm always just interested to see what where it is. I mean, it really all just starts with the songs with me, and songs to me are very much about melody. And so if I can find a melody that I find compelling, and then just the joy of creating the arrangement and the whole palette of making a record, it's the melody, it's the arrangement, it's the production, and all of that stuff is all part of the same palette for me. And that process is always a mystery. I have no idea ahead of time what it's going to be, and I'm often surprised by, oh, is that where that song is going? I didn't envision that. And that's the joy of it for me. It's not having a preconceived goal. It's me following the music where it takes me in my imagination. And that's really what it's all about for me. So I have no idea what's next. I mean, for instance, on the last record, I did a version of Skylark, which was a standard. I'd never covered a standard before my whole life. And I had this idea, it popped into my head one day, heard that song somewhere again and thought, gee, that's a beautiful melody. And then it got lodged in my head, and I started to hear it in my voice. And then I thought, well, how would I do that? And I created this arrangement, which I thought was pretty grooving, unique and interesting. And so, but it was a complete surprise to me. It wasn't like I'm gonna do a standard,
Well, how do you approach? So you definitely take a lot of ownership on the arrangements, and more so as, like you're saying, as a composer. How do you approach writing? Do you is it things that you start from what you hear first? Are you at the piano or at the saxophone? Kind of where do you feel most comfortable to start with the compositional process? Because I'm sure it's different for everybody, and like you're saying, it kind of comes to you. So is there a way that you approach composition? Is it like you're saying, you wait till it builds up and it just pours out? How do you approach the compositional process?
Well, it kind of varies. I mean, I have an old school memo recorder.
Hey, I know
Uses
those.
I
It's like a
since before since
pre-Zoom.
before I since before I had a smartphone, I've had this thing. And so even though I have a smartphone now, I still generally sing things into this. And I don't know why that is, but I do. Lots of times I'll scrap a melody will pop into my head and I'll sing it into there. Or if I'm practicing, every now and then I'll bump up on something. For instance, there's a song on the new record called Luna, which starts with this keyboard arpeggio. I had been practicing my horn, and I started. It was some part of the horn was sticking a little bit, and I wasn't doing what I wanted. So I started arpeggiating around these notes, and I thought, wait, maybe that's a keyboard line. So I played it on the keyboard, and I thought, oh, that's cool. And then I added these chords to it. It's like, oh, wait, it's a Latin thing. I had no idea it was going to be. So it started as an arpeggio on the horn, which turned into a keyboard arpeggio, which turned into this whole other thing. Sometimes I'll be practicing, I'll put it in the melody into the memo recorder. Other times I'll just sit at the piano and maybe mess around with chords just for fun, and that'll turn into something. So it's all kinds of ways. I think the real challenge or the discipline that you need to have when you're an artist and you have to keep creating content over a span of 28 years I've been doing it now, is to sort of know when you're getting an idea and that you need to put it down in some way so it doesn't go away. And then come back to it and just keep poking at it until can that be a song,
Well, I mean, the way you describe it, I totally understand why it's so much fun, because I mean, you don't, like you're saying, it's just it continually, you're like, this lick turned into something else, which turned into something else, and you couldn't have at any point known that that's how it was gonna go.
it's pretty wild. It
So
is
yeah,
fun.
you're like,
It's
oh,
fun.
well, I guess this is my album. You're doing it.